Hi students, in this special video we are going to discuss about structure of atom in comparison with structure of Shivalingam. Shivalingam is a representation of atom or not. So before going to our session, let me wish you and your family members a very happy new year. I wish all of you to achieve your dreams in the upcoming academic year. Now let's start our session. Is Shivalingam represents atom or not? Now first of all, look at the structure of Shivalingam. It basically have three parts. The lower part we call it as Brahma, the middle part we call it as Vishnu, and the upper part we call it as Shiva. Here Brahma is a creator, Vishnu is a preserver, and Shiva is destroyer. As like electron, neutron and proton in an atom. If you take atom, we have proton and neutron in the nucleus, electron around the nucleus. Here the Brahma is creator as like electron. Now without electron you can't create anything, because we have to form hydrogen molecule, two hydrogen atoms must share electrons. Without the presence of electron, you can't create hydrogen molecule. If you want to create sodium chloride, sodium must transfer electron to chlorine, so it will form NaCl. As like Brahma, a creator, the electron also creator. Now let's compare neutron with Vishnu, who is preserver. Here neutron will nullify the repulsion between the protons in the nucleus and maintain the stability of an atom and the nucleus as well. If you take atom, inside we have protons and neutrons. Here the protons have positive charges. There will be inter-positive repulsions. To nullify that, the neutron will reduce the proton-proton repulsion and makes the atom stable. So neutron act as a preserver. Finally, the proton or Shiva, which is going to be a destroyer. If you remember, if there is alpha particle or any proton which is highly reactive, which can be easily releasing the radiation and which always produce huge amount of energy once a nucleus is disturbed. As like Shiva, who is having highest energy in him. And we can understand by this, the proton is like Shiva, neutron is like Vishnu, and the electron is like Brahma. Now, the Shiva, or the upper part of the linga, is always kept under water. There will be some amount of water, or the cooling agent will be kept on Shivalingam to control the radiation effect of the top part of the lingam. As we are controlling the reactivity of few elements, sodium, potassium or phosphorus. Phosphorus kept under water to reduce its reactivity. Sodium and potassium kept under kerosene to reduce their reactivity. Because some elements will have more reactivity, to control them we have to use some solvent. As like we are controlling the higher power source of lingam Shiva by using certain amount of water. If you observe, there are different types of atoms. Different types of atoms. And there are different types of lingams. There are 12 types of lingams. And there are metal atoms, non-metal atoms, metalloids, as well as radioactive elements. Here metals, again they divide into solid, liquid and gas, as well as non-metals, solid, liquid, gas, and metalloids, solid, liquid, gas, and radioactive elements, solid, liquid and gas. They can exist. So here altogether we can get 12 states with the different metals. Here we have 12 lingams. Now here we can clearly understand The structure of a lingam is similar to structure of atom, and types of lingams are different types of atoms. So based on this, we can conclude in Indian mythology, in Indian philosophy, already they have mentioned the structure of atom long before the particles of atom are discovered. If you observe, the particles of atoms, protons, neutrons, electrons are discovered close to 19th century or at the end of 18th century. But long before that, they have mentioned about structure of atom in Indian philosophy. Hope you understand and enjoy the session.